From the hallowed grounds of Fenway Park, we've got open-air baseball for you on the show. It's the New York Yankees and the Boston Red Sox. First pitch coming your way next. So almost ready to get underway. And today's starter, Cutter Crawford.
Well, he comes at hitters with a five-pitch mix, so for him, it's always interesting to see how he utilizes those weapons. He may lean on one or two pitches depending on how things are going and how things are working, but if he can control four or even five of those offerings, look out, hitters. It's going to be a tough day. He's really going to be able to keep
leading
those guys off balance.
Yankees,
all right, ready to get underway. Baseman. Here's the veteran DJ. Second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. That's inside, and this one is off and running.
First pitch, 7 o'clock.
Next offering is in for a strike. Fouled off down the right side.
A little tardy on that fastball. He's going to have to get it going a little quicker. Get that front foot down.
1-2 here. And now 2-2. Next offering misses, and the count's full. Out towards right center field, and that's a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
You know what they say, he couldn't have thrown it out there any better than that, and certainly the case that time. Just flared it back behind the second baseman and dropped it in there.
It's Aaron Judge now. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Runner at first with no outs here. The next offering misses, and the count is 2-0. There comes an 0-2 to Judge. That one hooked foul. Two and one on Judge. That one missed. And the right-hander's 3-1. A little bit low, and Judge takes the walk.
Maybe a little loss of focus on the mound right there. Pretty much gifted him first base with a quick free pass.
Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. In the air, out towards right center. Verdugo going back on this one. And he makes the catch. Runner tags at second. Applies the tag, and they get two. Double play.
Batting fourth, the designated hitter, Labor Torres.
Here is the young phenom, Gleyber Torres. Next offering is down low. 1-0. pitch. That one in the dirt, and a count 2-1. Two outs. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. Move to first, and Judge back in safely. Two, two down. And now the count filled up 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Righty delivers. Up the middle. And base hit. Throw stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Benintendi up here. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. One now.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
The 2-1. And that one fouled off. Righty to the plate. And another ball. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Two on, two outs. Nice grab.
Generally, not the type of great play you expect from a first baseman, but he does a great job of hauling that one down.
Back in Boston, and on the hill in this one, Frankie Montas.
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot, the same tunnel, and that can make life very difficult on his opponents.
Back inside Fenway Park, digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Jarren Duran. Here's a high chopper in plenty of time to first. One up, one down.
Batting second.
Time now to check out the lineup for the Boston Red Sox. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience singing.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These guys have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
That one fouled hard the other way. And there's a foul ball. Next pitch is outside. One down, base is empty. And that one fouled off.
Five foul balls in this at bat so far, and these guys are going head to head. You can see the crowd. They're starting to get into it a little bit more, even though there hasn't been a ball in play yet.
That one misses. Two balls, two strikes. The wind of the pitch. Line drive caught.
Batting third, the third baseman, Rafael Devers.
Devers now. He's got the power, but great contact skills. One of the best contact hitters in the game. And a foul ball. Line to second, snagged on the bounce. And very nicely done for the out.
Making it look easy at the Keystone position. Definitely worth another look. He'll get some high fives when he gets into the dugout.
Back here at Fenway, now it's Josh Donaldson's turn to hit. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy is at the top of the list.
Stud. When you look at players like this, you play that hot corner, got to be pretty courageous over there with the way balls come off the bat. That's the kind of guy that every year you expect him to be in the All-Star game and have a gold glove, if not a platinum glove.
Next offering is in for a strike. James Kingsley, our plate umpire, consistent, as you mentioned, and maybe a little generous on the edges. And the 0-2. Swing and a miss. Struck him out and quickly won away in the second.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
Aaron Hicks now. So what are the skills you look for that make a really good defensive third baseman that elite?
Well, Boog, one of the things I think about immediately are just the feet. Does he have good feet? Is he able to quickly react? And when you have good feet, you've got soft hands. And soft hand defenders are able to make tough plays look easy.
The 1-1. Curveball drops in for a strike.
Down one and two.
The pitch. Look out! And it hit him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him.
Well, the bad news is that pitch wasn't close. The good news, they're set up to turn two and get out of the inning.
Here's Jose Trevino. And that's in there for strike one. Second inning here, no score. Next pitch inside, ball one.
Curveball kind of backed up on him there. I think it just slid out of the hand a little bit too soon.
And the righty deals. And there's the strike.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there. Really good pitch to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be a pitch that he turns on.
Moved first. Hicks back in on a dive. No score here in the second. and a swing and a miss. And there's two away.
He came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way. But that time,
the shortstop,
little anxious.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate. In there, and it's 0-1. Next offering is in for a strike.
Perhaps not quite ready to hit. First two pitches by him for a couple of strikes. Now back is against the wall. He's going to have to figure something out and figure it out quickly.
In the air, left field. Pham moving under it. Drops into the glove. And that will end the inning. The Yanks leave one. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Back here at Fenway Park, bottom half of inning number two. Joe stepping in for Boston. Xander Bogaerts.
Not shortstop.
Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average. But one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. Swings and misses. Strike one. They're so reliant on the matchups nowadays, Chris, and it's huge when you don't have to sit a guy or platoon him.
When you can hit, you know, both sides in terms of pitcher's arms, you're a guy that it's hard to take out of the lineup, and I think it's very important today when everything is under the microscope.
Next one misses, and it's 2-1. Swings through that one out front that time. Got him swinging. Xander Bogaerts a little frustrated. Now it's J.D. Martinez.
The designated hitter, J.D. Martinez.
In there for strike one. Nothing, nothing here in the bottom of the second. Next offering is down low. Here's a 1-1.
Count is 2-1.
Next offering misses down and away.
Three balls, one strike.
Fouls one away, and now 3-2. The wind of the pitch. That one drilled left field. And Benintendi able to make the grab. That's out number two.
Batting fifth, the right fielder, Alex.
Two outs, base is empty. Here's Alex Verdugo. And the first pitch misses for ball one. The next pitch misses. Two balls, no strikes to count. Two down, nobody on. There's a strike.
If he doesn't get a knock right here, that pitch he just took is going to eat at him for a while. You might not see another pitch like that from a top-level guy like this.
Swings and misses. And now 2-2. The pitch. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. Down in order go the Red Sox. We'll move to the third with no score. Back now at Fenway. Top half of the third inning. DJ LeMahieu will get things going.
The second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
The pitch. That one misses, and that is ball one. Kicks and fires. And now two and nothing.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
Next pitch misses, and now 3-0. And here it comes. And that one clips the corner.
It's a good spot with the 3-0 pitch right there. You don't want to lay something in and it turns out to be a homer.
Bounce to the left side. And that's just foul. Payoff pitch. Line drive, base hit right center field.
Pretty much a model swing on that one as he ripped it into the opposite field gap, and I'm sure he's going to be watching that one back on video because that's the kind of swing you want to bottle. So many positives that led to that knock.
Here comes Aaron Judge. Pitch misses inside. Ball one.
Well, here's a good opportunity in this inning to get on the scoreboard after that leadoff hit, and part of the order coming up right behind him. This is where they need to get going.
Next pitch is downstairs.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
The 2-0 is in for a strike. Top of the third, no score. Swing and a miss. It's 2-2. And the next pitch is way outside.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
At the belt and fires. Stays alive. The pitch. That one hammered, but pulled foul. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at bat. Got him looking. One away.
Really good battle right there. And that final pitch probably could have gone either way. He was hoping he'd get ball four. Instead, the umpire rings him up for the backwards K.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. First pitch just misses. Left-hand batter waits.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity. Try to get a rollover, something on the ground. Stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
Out towards left center. Coming on is Pham to make the play. Two away.
Every day during batting practice, these outfielders get about 10 minutes of balls in the gaps. They practice this, and when the game comes, they make the play perfectly.
Here comes Gleyber Torres. First offering misses the mark. The next offering misses. Ball two. Line to left and foul ball.
It's so hard to slow yourself down when you see that juicy breaking ball, but the most success happens when you try to take that right back up the middle approach.
And it's fouled away. And a pitch. Oh, that ball drilled back up the box and nailed the pitcher. He doesn't have a throw, and they can't get the out.
Now batting.
Andrew Benintendi up to the plate.
Benintendi.
On the ground to Devers. Slings it across, and Benintendi is out. That's the third out. We head down to the home half of inning number three. We're tied, nothing, nothing. Bottom of the inning, here's the veteran first baseman, Eric Hosmer.
Leading off for the Red Sox, the first baseman, Eric Hosmer.
Montas back to work. And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch is downstairs.
That's a really good take right there. Slider down and in. Very difficult to get on the same plane and do anything with.
Ball and a strike. And that one missing low. And a pitch. That one finds the corner. And the count's even at two. Here comes a pitch. Left field. And Benintendi able to make the grab. And there's one down.
Batting eight, the second baseman, Christian.
Here's Christian Arroyo. That one's in there, 0-1. Next offering is in for a strike.
That's excellent location on the fastball right there early in this game. If he can do that all game, should be a good outing for him.
Smoked on the ground a second. Gathers and throws to first. And two straight set down to begin the bottom of the third.
The catcher, Kevin.
Here's Kevin Plawecki. Next pitch downstairs, and it's 1-0. And the right-hander deals. That one's in there, and a count 1-1. And now the count 1-2 after the swing and the miss. Lifted in the air, right center field. Hicks is there for it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Red Sox go down 1-2-3, and we are still scoreless. Back here in Boston, here's Josh Donaldson.
Leading off for the Yankees, the third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
A wind in the pitch. In the air, right field. Pulls up and it drops for a hit.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often. But right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one could get to it.
Here's Aaron Hicks. First offering, and it just misses. Nobody out, runner at first.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Next offering misses, 2-1.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
And a pitch. Runner takes off on the ground, right side. Whips it to first. And Hicks is out.
Well, he's doing a nice job of keeping the ball out of the air. Lets the defense work behind him with another ground ball. Good execution.
Jose Trevino.
And next for New York, Jose Trevino. He was a strikeout victim his first time. And that's in there for strike one. Runner at second here, one gone. Foul ball there. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And he's down on strikes for the second time today. And the batter will be the shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
In there, and it's 0-1. Next offering is downstairs. Here's a 1-1. And that one is in for a strike. Two outs and one in scoring position. Next offering way off the plate. Man on second, two down. That one to first. He dives, but he can't make the catch. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. And that is that. One left for the Yankees. Still no score. And we're back here at Fenway Park. John Ciampi and Chris Singleton
leading
with
off.
You. And
we're
leading off the bottom of the fourth, Jaren Duran. Now the right-hander ready to go. Still no score. And that one is lifted in the air. Squeezes it. One down.
The left fielder, number 22, Tommy.
Here's Tommy Pham. First pitch, not close. The Red Sox yet to pick up a hit here. Next offering is in for a strike. The 1-1. Outside corner, there's a strike. And the pitch. And a ball evens the count. And downstairs. The pitch. And down on strikes he goes. And there are two outs. Two outs, bases empty. Rafael Devers up to him.
When he steps into the batter's box, the comfort level looks so high. It doesn't matter what kind of delivery that pitcher has, what kind of velocity, what kind of secondary stuff. He is so settled in there. He owns the home plate area.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Ball one there. That one ripped left field. And it slams off the bottom of the wall. Devers into second, and he's got a double.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. So close to blasting that one out of here the other way. But well, that's very tough to do when you take on the outfield gap like that. Beautiful swing, though. Let the ball get a little deep and drove it to the opposite field. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Right here's Xander Bogaerts now. In there for strike one.
The strategy of winning a ball game when you can make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four hole hitter up.
Runner leads away at second. Foul ball. Runner at second, two down. Next one misses, and a count one and two.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Two outs. Got him looking. And the inning is over. On to the top of the fifth we go. We're tied, nothing, nothing. We go to the top of the fifth. Here's the Yankees leadoff hitter, DJ LeMahieu.
The second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
The wide to kick the pitch. Hard hit to third. Over to Hosmer. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth.
Fastball groove right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
Now it's Aaron Judge up to the plate. Pretty good job on the mound in this one, Siggy. It feels like we've seen a lot of off-balance swings.
Yep, just one free pass, and obviously he's not a big strikeout guy, but he gets soft contact and he gets outs.
The wind of the pitch. Swing and a miss as he was out front. The Red Sox with some bullpen action. Brian Baio, the rookie right-hander, is getting loose. Whitlock warming up as well. Righty to the plate. That misses the zone. It's a ball and two strikes. Righty delivers. Judge rips that one. This one's got a chance. And that one is off the wall. Duran quickly gets it back in. Runner holds at second, so another base hit could get us the first run of the game.
Oh, here we are, third time through the order, and this is where we see the OPS jump up. Manager might have to go to the bullpen a little bit sooner than he anticipated.
Anthony Rizzo stepping in now for the Yankees. First offering misses badly for ball one. Man at second.
Let's see if he's willing to use the whole field right here. Definitely pounding him away.
The pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One out and a runner at second. Next pitch is inside. The count now 2-2. Kicks and deals. Pitch misses there, and the count's full. Foul ball, he stays alive. On the ground at first, and it finds its way through for a hit. Coming home, fires to the plate, tag, safe at home, and it's 1-0.
Always feels good when you come through and get your team on the board first. To me, it's just a really controlled, balanced swing. He wasn't trying to do too much with it. Just stay disciplined, got the barrel to the ball, and put it in play.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Cutter Crawford will depart, and as he heads for the dugout, we'll take a quick break. New arm on the mound when we get back. So they turn things over to the righty, Brian Baio. It's his job to keep his team in the game.
Well, at this point in the ball game, we're talking about middle innings, and you need a little length out of this arm coming out of the bullpen. We'll see just how many outs he's able to give his skipper.
Here is Gleyber Torres. Here comes the pitch. There goes the runner from first. Bounced up the middle. Throws to first. No chance at the double play with the runner in motion.
Well, he didn't recognize changeup earlier enough. Got out now in front a little bit, rolled over on it, and beat it into the ground.
Andrew Benintendi steps up.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion, and he's in full speed.
And the first offering is not close. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, that's really the money spot. Down and away, if you can locate that consistently, it's going to be real tough for guys to square that up. That's what you'd love to see relievers do coming out of that bullpen.
Here's a 1-1. And there's a ball. The 2-1. And a swing and a line drive at a right field. Verdugo makes the catch, and that'll do it. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's now 1-0. And welcome back. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Now it's the DH, J.D. Martinez.
The designated hitter, J.D.
Martinez. The wind of the pitch. He was late there. Strike one.
Oh, he's looking great so far. It helps when over 80% of your first pitches are strikes. He might be able to go the distance if he keeps this up.
Fouled off. He was late. Cut on and miss. Struck him out. One out.
Oh, there's a three-pitch strikeout. He can do whatever he wants with the baseball right now.
The right fielder, number 99, Alex Verdugo.
Now, Alex Verdugo. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Kicks and fires. And that one wrapped foul. The next pitch misses. One and two to count.
0-2 fastball way out of the zone. I think he's trying to speed him up. Got to stay back. Off speed's probably coming.
Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Hicks is there for it. Puts the squeeze on that one. And there's two down.
The first baseman, number 33, Aaron Hosmer.
And stepping in for Boston, Eric Hosmer. Hit it well, but flied out to the deepest part of the outfield his first time. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Next offering is foul back. Oh, and two now. And now one and two. One and two now. That one fouled off. The 1-2. That's inside.
This guy's a fun guy to watch taking it bat. He just battles up there. He doesn't take a pitch off at all. Makes it so difficult on the pitchers out there. You can tell they get frustrated with how long it takes to put him away.
Swing and a ball hammered left field, and that is a foul ball.
Now this offense has just been locked down. Almost five full innings of shutout baseball.
Next pitch misses, and a full count now.
Wow, this guy's really battling up there as if his run is the game-winning run. I love his tenacity.
Swing, and this one's bounced on the ground. Throw on to Rizzo. That's the inning. Nothing doing for Boston. They still trail 1-0. Welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. Now the third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
The third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
And he deals. In for a strike. And that is strike one. Boston's bullpen with some activity. Austin Davis, a left-handed reliever, appears to be getting loose. The pitch. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Just kept it simple. Played Pepper with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from. And there's just no one there to knock it down.
Now here's Aaron Hicks. And that's in there for strike one. And here it comes. Right field down the line, and that one slices foul. At the belt and fires. Gonna count one and two. Left hand batter waits. And that one almost got him. Right handed reliever. At first by Hosmer, puts the tag on him, and it's a double play. Jose Trevino stepping in now for the Yankees, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Is there a little wrinkle to that? I think there was.
Yeah. Little slider action.
Rolled over to third, and it goes just foul. The 1-1. Good eye right there. Fouls one off. 2-2. Broken bat, and it's popped up. Over to Hosmer, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. 8-9-1 scheduled in the bottom of the sixth. Yankees 1, and the Red Sox nothing. Well, we go bottom six. Joe stepping in for Boston, Christian Arroyo.
For the Red Sox.
Well, these fans definitely want to get involved in the game. All it's going to take is to get the leadoff man or even a base runner on.
Montas back to work. He swings and misses at the first pitch. 0-1. And the righty deals. Up the middle. Sends it to first. One away, bottom of the sixth.
The batter, the catcher, Kevin Plawecki.
And now Kevin Plawecki, 0 for 1. He was robbed of a hit on a diving catch his first time up. And the first pitch misses for ball one. The 1-0. Slapped foul. Next offering is down low. And a pitch.
That's ball three.
Well, these guys have had a hard time scoring in this one. The guy out there on the mound wants to keep attacking, make sure that they don't get any confidence.
Swing and a miss, and it's a full count now.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there. Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
And a swing and a miss. And there's two away.
Oh, really expanded the zone right there with that fastball off the outside corner of the plate. Got him to chase it. That's a tough one to lay off of because it starts close to you and just continues to run away from you in that batter's box. So it's a really nice pitch with two strikes.
Now batting Jarren Duran. Swing and a ball lifted left field. That is the inning. Red Sox go down quietly, still behind by a count of 1-0. Back here at Fenway, new inning getting started. Here's the shortstop at the plate, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Right hander back to work. And the pitch is outside, ball one. Here comes a pitch. Up the middle. Arroyo whips it to first. And a quick out number one.
Up next for the Yankees, the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu.
Up to the plate steps DJ LeMahieu. First offering misses the mark. And the 1-0. On the ground, right side. Over to Hosmer, and two away to start the seventh.
Now batting, the right fielder, Aaron Judge.
Two outs, bases empty. Aaron Judge stepping in now for the Yankees. Pitch misses inside, and that's ball one. Righty to the plate. Out front and foul to the left side. Next pitch is downstairs. And Judge spoils that one. Two down, nobody on. Smash to the left side. Base hit. And that keeps the inning going.
Showed some really nice patience in that at bat. Worked himself into a good count. Pretty tough for the infielders to do anything with that one. He pulled it hard into the outfield. And even when you keep it on the ground, it feels great when you hit a missile like that.
Two outs, runner at first. And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Rizzo. Got to be careful with a slugger like this because he can turn it into a three-run game in the blink of an eye. The 1-0.
Two count to a guy like this at the plate, you've got to throw a pitcher's pitch. Don't just try to get a strike. He could make you pay.
Throw over to first, and Judge back in safely. Next pitch is outside.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
Three-one now. And fouled off.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score it.
Throw to first, and he's back in safely. Three, two now. And that is ball four, and the Yankees are in business.
Not what he wanted to do right there, Boo. That keeps this inning alive, puts a runner in the scoring position, and a chance for this offense to add on to their lead.
First and second, two down. Gleyber Torres stepping in now for the Yankees.
Looking for some insurance, or as our friends down in the South would say,
insurance.
No matter how you say it, we know what you mean.
That one's in there, 0-1. First and second, two down. Next one is off the plate, and that's ball one. Line drive. Yanks strand a pair. They lead it 1-0.
Seventh inning stretch.
Back here at Fenway, ready to go for the last half of the inning. Here's the left fielder, Tommy Pham.
The left fielder, Tommy Pham.
Red Sox fans are frustrated, no question. The pitch. And a good eye there. Activity in the bullpen for the Yankees. Wandy Peralta, the left-hander, up and throwing. Loaisiga, a hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. Looking to get the tying run on base. Swing and a miss. And it's 1-1. Just missed.
You don't want to get beat by a fastball in. And he spits on that one.
Next pitch is outside.
Expect for that guy to come right at you with a fastball, something in the zone, because he does not want to allow the leadoff walk.
The tying run at the plate. Fouls one away, and now 3-2. And the right-hander deals. Fought off foul. Three, two on the way. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you get the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
And it's Rafael Devers in the box. First pitch, not close. The next offering misses, and that's ball two. The wind and the pitch. Misses with the 2-0, and he's fired three straight outside the strike zone. Here's a 3-0. So Devers will take his base. How big a deal is that walk?
I don't think it's a big deal, because if you pitch to the previous hitter with the power he has, he can hit a home run. I think it was a calculated walk. We'll see how it pays off here.
base hit into the outfield. Here comes the throw, and he's safe. So it's first and third with one down.
Just a clutch at bat right there. Big time swing when this team really needed it. Maybe a little out front of the pitch right there, but he squared it up pretty good, and he kept it inside the line. And just a really nice job on the other side by the defense to hold that to a long single.
Now a pretty big at bat coming up with a chance to even this ball game up.
His fans, they are ready to cheer about something.
They say it went. One out. The possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. And one and two.
These home fans, they are making a lot of noise, putting pressure on that pitcher out there.
The 1-2. Base hit and a run comes in. The tying run is in to score, and we are starting over. We're tied at one.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. Now a huge at bat in this game coming up.
First and second, one out. And now the right fielder, Alex Verdugo. First offering misses badly for ball one. The pitch. That's down and in.
99 pitches, about to throw his 100th here in the seventh inning. This is where you really start looking for any signs of fatigue.
2-0. And misses inside. Two on, one out. That just missed. He walked him on four pitches. And here comes the Yankees manager to the mound. Pitching change coming. Montas is done in this one, and it's a tie ball game as he heads for the dugout. Back with a new arm after a quick break. Number 97 into the game, and he's on the deal with the bases loaded.
Number 97.
So bases loaded with one away. And now the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. And there's no doubt that they'll feed off the energy from this crowd, right?
I mean, yeah, I'd say the intensity level has gone up a few notches for sure.
First offering, and it just misses.
This is a situation where the hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can get his arms extended. What you have to be careful of is that pitch that's up, that's in on your hands. That'll pop you up in the infield, and that's exactly what the pitcher wants.
Kicks and fires. He swings and fouls one off. And a pitch right through there for a strike. And now the count is even. Right-hander kicks, deals, and a swing and a miss. Huge strikeout there.
Certainly a strikeout situation right there. The infield playing back, and this pitcher has to step up and give the swing and miss. Really nice job of attacking the hitter at the plate. Pretty big two-out at bat coming up now.
So up next, Christian Arroyo. Pitch misses inside. 1-0. Bases loaded. 2 down. Next offering is in for a strike. Two outs. And a count 1-2. The pitch. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. And a 1-2 again. Strike three, got him swinging. Good job at damage control right there.
Well, this guy competes hard. We see the emotion there. I love it. Great job of getting out of the jam.
For the top of the eighth, there's Benintendi to start it off.
Leading off for the Yankees, the left fielder, Andrew.
The right-hander back to work. Line drive, base hit.
Well, no waiting around right there. He was ready to swing it up on the first pitch. Nice line drive to the pull side. Met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
So a change being made at first base. And here's the pinch runner, Tim LoCastro. So digging in, Josh Donaldson. First pitch, just misses.
If you're a base runner, you've got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Next offering is in for a strike. Righty delivers. There's a strike.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base. Try to stay out of a double play here.
Next pitch is outside. Pickoff throw, and LoCastro dives back in. The go-ahead run aboard at first. Nobody out. Next offering is down low. Full count 3-2. And a pitch. On a line. Coming on is Pham to make the play. And they take care of Donaldson for the out. And there's one down.
Now back, the seventh fielder, Aaron Hicks.
Aaron Hicks stepping in now for the Yankees for the fourth time tonight.
Well, with pretty good speed over there at first base, I think the pitcher's got to slow everything down. Hold the ball a little bit, step off, just try to break the rhythm and timing of a potential base stealer.
Bayo keeping him close. In there, and it's 0-1. LoCastro on the run. Ball outside. throw to second. Great jump, and that is a stolen base. It wasn't even close.
When your catcher's not a great thrower, you have to do a better job at controlling the running game, and that's throwing over, that's stepping off, doing whatever you can to try to keep that base stealer's rhythm off. Well, they weren't able to do it right there. They're going to have to make some type of adjustment, or guys are going to be running all game.
Runner goes again. Pitch misses, and that's a stolen base, not even close.
I'd say an aggressive roll of the dice there to steal third in this spot, but they felt good about it, and it worked out. Now the game plan changes a little bit at the plate to get that go-ahead run home. The defense might pull the infield in.
And a pitch. And a foul ball. The pitch. Swung on, popped up left side. And there's two down.
The catcher, number 39, Jose Trevino.
Jose Trevino digs in now. This is what stat nerds like myself might call a high leverage situation.
Yeah, Boog, not sure what the numbers say, but clearly an at bat that could change the course of this game dramatically.
Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field. That's back there. Pulls it in on the warning track. The Yanks lead one. Score remains tied 1-1. Tim LoCastro. He's out in left field getting loose there as he enters the game on defense now. So they turn to Lou Trevino. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise.
Now pitching for New York, number 56.
Back here in Boston, ready for the bottom of the eighth. And now it's the catcher for the Red Sox, Kevin Plawecki.
The catcher, Kevin Plawecki.
The pitch. Ball one, no strikes.
If you're the pitcher, you've got to go right at this guy. It's the number nine hitter in the lineup. You can't be afraid of contact in this situation.
And the 1-0. And that one off the outside edge. That misses, and now 3-0. So definitely a little wild right out of the gate.
Well, it can be a little tough coming from the bullpen mound to this mound, but you've got to find a way to get ahead in the count quickly. He has it. We'll see how this at-bat turns out.
It's a leadoff walk, and that's the go-ahead run. Now here's the Red Sox leadoff hitter, Jaren Duran.
Leadoff man is on. You've got to be looking for the bunt here. Trying to get him into scoring position.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. And he deals. And a sack bunt here. LeMahieu. Feed to second. That's one. Out there, but that's all they'll get.
Now batting. Left fielder. Tommy Pham.
Tommy Pham up next for the Red Sox.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
Next pitch downstairs. Ball one. One away. Tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. Next one is off the play. And that's ball two. Kicks and deals. And a base hit right there. And a go-ahead run into scoring position. One away.
Well, when you fall behind in the count, you've got to come into the zone, and then guys have a better chance of hitting the ball hard like he did right there.
And here is Devers.
Now that the third baseman, Rafael Devers.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Yeah, Berube, if you're that base runner at second base, you want to be quiet out there. Not bouncing around, not distracting your teammate, the hitter. Make sure that he can clearly focus on that pitcher and that release point.
At the belt and fires. Strike two.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time it gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
And that one fouled off. Next pitch just misses, and it's 2-2. And now the count filled up 3-2. So now 3-2. Got him looking. Two away.
Big strikeout there as he works to strand that go-ahead run at second base. But job's not done yet. Got to get that last out before you can exhale and get back into the dugout. It's kind of tough to do with this home crowd applying so much pressure.
And here is Xander Bogaerts. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at all. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now. And the next pitch is way outside. And now it's 1-2. Stays alive. Hits softly on the ground to third, and he grabs it, foul. The 1-2. And a foul ball, he stays alive. And here it comes. Swing and a miss, struck him out. They miss a big chance to take the lead here late.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
All set to start the ninth in this one. Now it's the shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
The shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
And a pitch. And the slider just misses. Slice to right. Base hit into the outfield. So the go-ahead run is on base with a knock.
Well, a big swing of the bat right there. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Back to the top of the Yankee order. Now it's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. And the first offering is not close. Trying to move him over here. Arroyo tosses to first, and that's an out on the sacrifice.
Now batting, right fielder, Aaron Judge.
And now big number 99, Aaron Judge.
Listen, there's absolutely no reason to pitch to this guy right here. You nibble, you see if he'll expand his zone, but don't give him anything to hit. If you walk him, not a big deal. You have a double play opportunity set up.
First offering misses the ball. One out. The go-ahead run is at second. Next offering is in for a strike. That misses the zone, and it's 2-1.
Really been able to slow down the game tonight with his at-bats, and the biggest one he's had so far, he doesn't look anxious at all.
And it's second. And a swing and a miss.
Well, there's a certain point where you have to commit to what you think you see, and he guessed wrong right there. Nasty slider with just terrific bite at the end.
Ground ball up the middle. Bogarts handles the chance. On to first. Judge out on the play.
Now batting, the first baseman, Anthony Rizzo.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. Now be careful with this guy. He's got power. He can untie it with one swing. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And the righty deals. So two balls and no strikes. Left-hand batter waits.
I'm sorry, that's a ball.
That one ripped, but foul.
Starting to get some pretty good timing on that breaking ball, but he's going to have to stay ready for a fastball. Don't want to watch one go right by you.
And a 3-1 on the way. Fouled off left side.
As a hitter, you don't know what to expect here in the 3-2. If he'll throw a breaking ball 3-1, he'll do it again 3-2.
3-2 now. On the ground, right side, and it's just foul. That is close. The pitch. Right through there, got it. Down on strikes, and he knew it. One left for the Yankees. Score remains deadlocked at one. New pitcher for the Yankees, Lucas Litke.
Number 63, Lucas Litke.
Back now at Fenway, and now the DH, J.D. Martinez.
Leading off for the Red Sox, the designated hitter, J.D. Martinez.
The pitch. Going away.
Well, and a bat can be a little bit of a dance, strike one here, but a few more pitches. We'll see how it turns out.
On the ground to first. And he takes it himself for the out.
Now batting, right fielder, Alex Verdugo.
Digging in, Alex Verdugo.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is that I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
And that's in there for strike one. Movement in the Yankees' pen. Clay Holmes up and throwing. Chapman, a left-hander, also throwing. And now the lefty pulls that one foul. All tied up here in the last half of inning number nine. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And a couple of quick outs.
Well, clearly just anxious right there, number and understandably so in an 0-2 count. You feel like you've got a lot of plate to cover, and you don't want to strike out, and you end up striking out. That's just one of those pitches where it's not over the plate, but because you committed to it as it was leaving his hand, by the time you realized it wasn't going to be in the zone, it's too late to hold up your swing.
And first offering is fouled off. And that's downed away. Left-hand hitter waits. Swing and a miss as he was late that time.
Man, he was really tardy on that fastball. Great job of setting him up by throwing the curveball. Add some velocity to it on the next pitch. Can't catch up.
Next one misses. 2-2. Pitch. Good eye right there. Kicks and fires. On the ground to the left. Connor Falefa gloves it. Zips it to first. Red Sox go 1-2-3. Down in order go the Red Sox. Still tied 1-1. Back here at Fenway Park, and now the young star. It's Gleyber Torres.
The designated hitter, Gleyber Torres.
And the pitch. That one missed. Double barreled action in the bullpen. Austin Davis getting loose out there. Sawamura, the right hander, also getting loose. And here's a slow roller over to Hosmer. And Gleyber Torres retired.
That's what a good sinker is designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Tim LoCastro.
Now batting Tim LoCastro. Getting his first plate appearance here in extra innings. He entered the game as a pinch runner. pitch misses inside. Ball one. Up the middle. Sends it to first. Two in a row set down to start the 10th.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. The 1-0. There's the strike. Righty to the plate. Stays alive. Right-handed reliever. And that one is lifted in the air. Can't get there. Should be extra bases. Runner from third comes across. It's 2-1. And in its second with an RBI double.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one.
Aaron Hicks at the plate. And first offering is fouled off. Right-hander kicks, deals. Ripped to right, base hit. Runner holds at third, so even with two outs, they didn't risk it.
Back-to-back base hits, just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. Once in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it.
Now the catcher up to hit, Jose Trevino. He's built his reputation as one of the top framers in the sport. That one's in there, 0-1. Righty delivers. Bounced up the middle. They take the force out. Inning ends, and that stops the bleeding. Yankees strike for a run on the RBI double, and this is now a 2-1 ball game. So they turn to their closer, Clay Holmes. And he'll work on holding this lead.
Number 35, Clay Holmes.
Back inside Fenway Park. Here's the second baseman, Christian Arroyo.
For the Red Sox, the second baseman, Christian Arroyo.
And a pitch.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. When you get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it, but this is where they earn their keep.
and the 1-0. And that one moves his feet. Next pitch misses inside. Ball three. Appears they're working around him with the base open, Singy.
Well, you know, these 2-0 counts, Boo, they're just not what they used to be, and we sound like old guys when I say that, but ultimately, this is a strategic game, and you expect to see this type of approach by the pitcher in this situation.
Runner leads away at second. Next pitch in for a strike, 3-1. Next offering is fouled back. That one misses, so a leadoff walk.
Well, they didn't give him anything to hit, and now with runners on first and second, they've set up a double play opportunity. So not a terrible result.
Now a move being made at second base. Pinch running for Boston, Jalen Davis. First and second, no outs. Here's the catcher, Kevin Plawecki.
Oh, how he'd love to walk it off right here.
And he lays one down the left side. Donaldson. Off balance feed. There's one. Throw to first, but he beat it.
Now
tough play right there. Didn't really have enough time to set his feed and make a strong, accurate throw. Had to rush it, but he got it off, and he got it there in time to get that out at second base.
So the Red Sox lineup turns over. Here's a speed threat. Jarren Duran. And there's something you don't see very much in today's game, the pitch out. The 1-0. And he takes a strike.
Well, he had a pretty good look at that pitch and not sure exactly what tied him up there. Couldn't pull the trigger. And perhaps the best pitch he'll see in this at bat to hit.
Big spot, tying and winning runs aboard with one down. Next offering is in for a strike.
Big pitch right here. He's going to try to make a pitch that's going to produce a strikeout or a ground ball double play.
The 1-2. And the 1-2 misses to even the count. So now with one swing, this guy could end it. Slowly on the ground to short. Off balance feed, there's one. And he'll eat it and be happy with the out. So two down now, and here is Tommy Pham. In there for strike one.
Well, if he's going to steal second, you want him to go early in the count. That way he's not a distraction to the hitter at the plate. Go ahead and get it out of the way so the hitter can focus on the pitch.
Two outs. Misses outside, and it's a ball and a strike.
The only adjustment he needs to make is his target. If you aim at the outside corner, that slider's going to end up way off the plate. Perhaps look a little more down the middle, and you get it right where you want it.
In there. And so now 1-2. Two outs, but the winning run is at first. And a swing and a miss. The hat trick. That ends the frame. On to inning number 11 we go. We are tied 2-2. New pitcher on now, Hirokazu Sawamura.
Number 18, Hirokazu Sawamura.
Bobby Dalbec getting loose there. He's now in the game at first.
Number 29.
And we're back here at Fenway Park. And the batter will be the shortstop, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. Man at second, nobody out. Chris, certainly one of the things in his head is trying to get the runner over.
Yeah, the way that we see the game played today, though, guys are not sacrificing as much just to get that runner across. They're really looking at doing damage. Slugging is the name of the game.
Next offering is in for a strike. Next pitch is outside. Two on now. And another ball.
It's getting squeezed a little bit here late.
This one popped up. Foul ground, first base side. Brings it in. And there's one away.
Well, such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ball game and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit. And then from there can really settle in.
And now it's DJ LeMahieu digging in. In there, and it's 0-1.
Well, we call that keyhole. Even though it's right there and looks pretty good, if he doesn't love it, he's not going to swing that early in the count.
Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive.
Well, he knows they don't want to give him anything to hit, but when you've got opportunities to drive in runs, you've got to expand the zone. He's capable of going out there and doing damage with it.
Next pitch is inside. Now 1-2. And the right-hander deals. Stays alive. Pitch and a foul ball.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Got it. Now two away.
Nice work there to get the strikeout, and that's a big second out. I'll tell you, this home crowd will be fired up. They can get out of this and leave that go-ahead run stranded in scoring position. This is a big moment in this game.
So up next, Aaron Judge. This guy with light tower power. First offering misses the mark. Next offering is in for a strike.
One ball, one strike.
Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit.
Here comes the runner.
Now a long throw home. Not in time. He beat it, and they've got the lead.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. Man at second here with two away. And up next for New York, Anthony Rizzo. A strikeout and a walk. Intentional walk here with two out. They set up a force at any base to end the inning.
Well, it doesn't get much easier with this next batter, but now I totally understand going with the intentional walk in that spot. He's just too dangerous at the plate right now. And there's a base open, so it gives you options defensively to get an out.
And first offering is fouled off. Here comes a pitch. Way inside, gets out of the way.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Swing and a miss. And it's one and two.
Threw that fastball right by him, slightly elevated. That's a confidence boost for this guy out there on the mound. See if he continues to climb the ladder.
And a pitch. Yeah, that's downstairs and outside. The pitch. And a base hit on a line. Here comes the judge around third. And that'll pick off the base of the wall. Runner around third in to score. Another scores. Two runs in on the play. It's 5-2.
Picks himself up a couple of ribbies. I'll tell you, man, it's such a good feeling when you smoke a line drive into the gap like that. I mean, sure, home runs are king, but I feel like nothing makes you feel like a true professional hitter more than a bullet the other way.
Austin Davis will take over here. He'll try to strand the runner at second. And it's scoring position with two away. And stepping in is the speedy Tim LoCastro. Rolled out to second in his first at bat. On to first. That ends the inning and stops things from getting out of hand. But three score in the inning. Two of them on this two-run double. It's now 5-2. All set for the bottom of the 11th. Here's Rafael Devers. The Red Sox in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. Need a good at bat out of him right here.
And he deals. That one pushed foul. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike.
Talk about the right guy at the right spot. They really need a rally, and this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
Here's a 1-2. And a foul ball. He stays alive. And a swing and a miss. One gone here. It's Xander Bogaerts now. Siggy, he's got a history of coming through in the big spots. I know I like to talk about, I'm not sure whether clutch actually exists, but you look at the numbers, and this guy always seems to deliver in those spots. Rolled softly, but that goes foul. Oh, one down.
Well, I think it's the ability to assess the situation, understanding what the pitcher has, what he's trying to get people out on, and then being able to use the entire field.
At the belt and fires. So, a foul ball makes it 1-2. Yankees up by 3. We are in the 11th. That's the third. Rolls across the diamond. Only one out left for the Red Sox.
now batting, the designated hitter, J.D.
J.D. Martinez stands in. First offering way inside, almost got him. Yankees up by three, and here in extra innings. Swing and a miss. That's strike one.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
Next offering is in for a strike. Fastball, and he gets out of the way. Pulled down the line. This one hammered, but it's foul.
Clearly hoping he could get a swing and miss on that, but doesn't fool the hitter with that breaking ball. Nice job. Just couldn't keep it fair.
Slow roller to first. And that'll do it.
Well, I love the fact they didn't quit. They had to do a little extra work tonight to secure this win, but it's what you got to do over the course of a season if you want to be a championship ball club.
And your final score, 5-2. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, 5 runs, 15 hits, no errors. They left 14 men on base.